What's up, guys? Welcome back to Fisher Hex. My name is Travis. In today's video, I'm going to show you the two guaranteed ways that you can completely eradicate Aptasia pests and enemies from your reef tank and or, in my situation, my frag system. Now, if you've been following the channel for some time now, over the last couple years, I've been selling coral. I've been importing it from other wholesalers around the world, cutting it up, healing it, and getting it out to you guys via my website. Now, during that whole process, sometimes you get Aptasia, regardless of the dipping in the beginning and the cleaning of the coral, the rock that they come on. Sometimes you miss stuff and you get Aptasia. Now, over the last several months, I have noticed a lot of them popping up. And in this video, I'm going to show you the two methods that I use every single time to completely eradicate the Aptasia. So let's go ahead and get started. Now, on a side note, if you want to avoid this entire situation and the hassle of dealing with pests in general, go ahead and set yourself up a coral quarantine tank. Now, I will link a video in the description of the one that I have here in the fish room. Very easy to set up, and it works perfectly for finding those Aptasia, nudibranchs, flatworms, red bugs, all that kind of stuff. All you have to do is set it up, put your new coral in there, and observe and find that stuff. That way you can avoid it ever getting into your display tank. Now, with that said, let's go ahead and move on with the video. All right, so the first method I have here is the Majano wand. Now, I picked mine up from saltwateraquarium.com, and it's really easy to use. Now, the whole way that it works is basically it's a wand with a stainless steel tip, and you're going to be running a small amount of electricity through it. Now, when this interacts with the salt water, it turns into hydrogen gas, and when you touch a pest anemone, because it's primarily made up of water, it basically disintegrates the skin. So that's the short version of how it works, and it's really, really effective, and you guys will see that here in a minute. Now, I like to use the wand whenever I see an anemone pop up, get it early on, kill it, get it out of the tank. That way, it doesn't have a chance to spread and reproduce through the whole system. So let's go ahead and move over to the frag tank, and I'll show you guys exactly how it works. Now, here we're at the right top corner of the lowboy, and you can see I definitely have a few Aptasia in the frag rack. Now, as you go to touch the anemone, you want to make sure you turn the wand on, and you don't want it running around in the tank without it actually touching the anemone, because it is known to cause damage to it. Now, what you do is just go ahead and touch the anemone there, wait for it to start to disintegrate. Now, on the bigger ones, it's going to take a little bit longer. You want to try to get all of that flesh, making sure that it starts to detach and float to the surface, and then you can come through with a fishnet and get all that gunk out. Now, if you don't want to do that, you don't have to worry about it. It's not going to spread around the tank. It's not like it's still alive. It's completely disintegrated and basically mush at that point. So what I do is I just go around, kill all the anemones that I can reach with this wand, and it works every single time. Now, this is something you're going to want to do for a few minutes here and there, come back in a couple hours or maybe the next day and keep going. You don't want to keep doing this for hours and hours on end, because you will cause issues with your system with all of that hydrogen gas being introduced to the tank. Now, I do believe that it does come with a piece of paper telling you how long you can have it actually running based on the amount of water volume that you have in your tank. So just go ahead and check that out to make sure you're not overdoing it and causing issues with your system. But other than that, I really love this wand. It works really, really well. And for the price, you can't beat it. Now, there is only one downside to using this wand, and really the main reason why I have two methods, and this part of the frag rack is a perfect example of that. As you guys can see, there's a lot of anemones in through these PVC and where they actually connect to the frag rack where they feel safe. And they are, for the most part, as you can see, when I start to kill them, they all shrink up, go into their hiding places, and make them very difficult to kill with the wand. Now, over time, if you're persistent, you can definitely kill all these Aptasia. You're just going to have to come in here a couple times a day or every single day and just keep working at it. But if you want to bypass that, go ahead and move on to my second method, or in turn, use both of my methods, and you'll definitely get all the Aptasia regardless of where they're hiding in your frag rack or your main display tank. All right, so moving on to my second method, which is more of a natural approach by using a predator. This is a Bergia, I'm pretty sure I'm pronouncing it right. Either way, it's a Bergia nudibranch. Now, these guys only eat Aptasia. So once your tank is out of Aptasia, the nudibranch will starve to death. Now, one thing that I do here in the fish room is I get them in, I use them to kill the population of Aptasia, and then I get Aptasia rock from local hobbyists to kind of keep them alive, or at least keep their population somewhat going. So if I get any more Aptasia in on future orders, they're already there, ready to start eating them. Now, a couple things you want to take in consideration when you're getting these guys and when it comes to ordering them is, what kind of predators do you have in your tank? How big is your tank? That's all going to be stuff that you're going to want to take in consideration when ordering them. All else fails, order a lot of them, because I know the more you buy, the bigger the discount you'll get. That way, your wrasses and stuff who start picking them off, you'll have at least a couple in there that will hopefully reproduce and continue to eat the Aptasia. Now, in my frag tank, I don't have any wrasses, so I don't have to worry about that. but I will be adding them soon, so that might be something I'll have to take in consideration when trying to keep these guys alive. But either way, when you get them in, you're going to want to go ahead and slowly acclimate them. This time of year is definitely cold, so it takes about 45 minutes to an hour. You're slowly going to drain the water, add some water, drain some water, add some water, and keep doing that. The nudibranchs will wake up, keep moving around, and then after about an hour, you can go ahead and put them in your tank. Now, what I like to do is turn off all the flow for the exception of the return pump, put them near a rock so they can crawl out of the container up onto the rock and start going to town on the Aptasia. Now, one thing I recommend you do is order the medium to large nudibranchs. Now, the reason for this is the medium ones are ready to reproduce. Usually the order comes in with some eggs. I know it's just part of the whole process of getting them out. So having some eggs ready to go to reproduce and get new nudibranchs in the tank just betters your chances of taking care of the Aptasia. Now, what's really cool about these guys is it doesn't matter if the lights are on or off, they're out and about killing Aptasia 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. They just never seem to stop. And that's really cool because once they're eating, they're reproducing. You'll see babies here in a few days or weeks, depending on if you got any in during the shipment. And they just keep going. They don't stop. And as long as you have a food source and minimal predators, these guys are there to stay. Now, one thing I recommend you do if you don't want to add Aptasia to your tank to keep them alive, you can always catch them while they're on the glass, put them in your coral quarantine tank, and add Aptasia rock from local hobbyists or from another system. That way they have food and they can continue to reproduce. It's really up to you. I like to always keep them on hand regardless of what system I have, just in case an Aptasia pops up and I can nip it in the bud early on. Well, guys, that's about it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it and that it gave you an idea of some of the things that I do here in the fish room to allow my coral to be Aptasia free. Now, regardless if you buy from me or from somebody else, you should always quarantine your coral. It doesn't matter. That's the only way you can really ensure that no pests make it into your display tank. But either way, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, feel free to put in the comment section below. If you're looking for some one-on-one support, check out my new website, reeferoncall.com, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.